kids. 1,000 kids. 3 days on one stage. The best weekend of the year. This is Hardcore 2008.
I went to my first hardcore show. It was a Biohazard show and just fell in love. Like, that felt more normal to me than hanging out at parties and stuff. I walked in, I was like, wow, this is crazy. And it felt normal to me. It was like, felt like home in a way, and I just fell in love ever since.
With that temper, that button that gets pushed, and that mind. coming up here and coming to shows, it's good to have a festival that has like a lot of respect for itself, and a lot of people come and travel to where I grew up, you know, and started a band, and you know, I guess I got more interested like in the when I started Blacklisted. I didn't know Rights before that, but with Blacklisted, that was like me really doing a band. No Rights is just like me busting it up with some friends or something, you know. We'll be right back.
went to Love Park. We were there for 10 minutes. We saw four brutal fights within 10 minutes. We saw Black Train getting the shit kicked out of it. We saw a bunch of skateboarding kids get, like, just tackled by cops. I saw a black dude beat up a skateboarder. Yeah, three fights in 10 minutes. That was the best day. What's up, Philadelphia?
Amazing. I got chills through our entire set. I just couldn't stop smiling like an idiot. It was awesome. Yeah, that's true.
We had a good time. It was a really good reaction. I mean, we're from here, so. But, you know, I got no complaints. It was awesome. Last year was awesome. Hopefully, you know, we'll get to play another This Is Hardcore in the future.
Festival.
other festivals or other shows? Anything kind of stand out?
Well, I think this one is great because it's intimate enough. It's in one enclosed area, and there's, you know, it's maybe 1,000 kids, and Joe does a great job. It's not 7,000 kids outside for, you know, Warped Tour and where you just get lost with everything that's going on. This is a great number of bands and a great place.
That's the thing. You don't see hardcore festivals in the States like you do overseas, you know, so you don't see an intimate club festival like this anywhere else. So this would be the only one that we've ever actually played.
They need better air conditioning now.
Looking for some better music that meant something when I was a teenager.
I got into it through skateboarding, you know, just reading Thrasher magazine.
I grew up listening to punk rock. It was kind of snowball, hardcore. That's it. It's kind of a natural progression.
We'll be right back. before 2008. We're about to talk to Robbie Redchick, who's getting ready to set up for his interview.
Yeah, I got
scared. This is great.
My first week in Philadelphia, went to a show, Lifetime. And at the first Unitarian Church, there was 50 people watching Lifetime play on the floor. You see it grow from that moment to this moment. I mean, yeah, there's, what, 1,000 something people here? Like, I would say a third of the list of bands playing are all from Philadelphia. That's something everybody in the Philadelphia community can be proud of. There's so much going on, you know, that it's all one big happy family.
So a lot of these bands playing, they're fucking struggling, you know? So keep that in mind when you when you're downloading someone's fucking music, or you're too cool to fucking show up to their show or whatever the fuck it is. But you have all the time in the world to sit on your fucking ass and talk shit on the internet.
Thank you.
Hardcore 2008 documentary. Ceremony. You guys, amazing. What do you think of This Is Hardcore?
Well, we like it. We've been here, this is our third year. We love the dudes and shit. We're all cool with everyone. But it's a lot different from California, you know? It's like a whole different world here. East Coast, it's much different than California. We don't know as many people, and we feel a little bit out of place.
Yeah.
You know, we're like...
Yeah, it'll all come to time.
But, I mean, it's cool. Like, everyone shows us a lot of respect. Everyone's really cool, so yeah. It's all good.
Yeah, it's fun. It's fun. It's always fun. Our sets are always fun.
Yeah.
Definitely feel a little bit out of place sometimes, but it's definitely fun.
When you have to. So I'm throwing bricks.
California.
That's what's up.
West.
You want to live on the best coast, you better try to move to the West Coast.
From the Netherlands, Europe, This Is Hardcore is pretty much the fest on the East Coast. So for us, being from Europe as only band at the moment, right here, I think it's an honor. And we can play for more people than just like a regular local show.
It's a good chance to let people in the States know what European hardcore is all about, you know?
And this old school, stay alive! I'm
that we can make a difference, but we can.
Thank you. Darkroom this year and Sound of Fury were two of the best shows we ever had in Japan. So one thing that I always find is funny is that growing up, I always thought the people from like the Midwest and the South and like, I guess their architecture and their towns would be so different from us, but really, well, we're all a lot more similar, I think, than we think with us in time. The only thing I think the West Coast has about us is weather, and Alberger, Corey Williams.
Probably skateboarding for me.
Yeah, same thing for me, man. Skate videos with punk and hardcore bands, you know, middle school checking shit out. Like, what the fuck is this? Bad Brains on a skate video, you know? So.
Give it up. These are some fun songs. This song's called Skate or Die. We'll be right back.
One thing I like about this fest more than like others is, you know, you have like the heavy hardcore bands and you have like the youth crew kids and then, you know, the sing-along-y, whatever, melodic hardcore bands, whatever. You know, like a lot of fests like stick to like one genre and it's like, I don't know, it seems kind of stuck up to me when this covers like all types of hardcore bands, and I think that's how the scene needs to be, so I think that's one of the best things about this fest.
Like little punk shows, and then I discovered Metallica, and then like I'd own a guitar, and just like some friends from high school got me to start going to shows, and like I don't know, I just ended up in hardcore bands pretty quick.
Skateboard, Vision of Disorder, 25 to Life, those kind of bands.
Probably just going to shows, blowing one, getting hammered, hanging out with my friends.
First year playing, this is hardcore. What do you guys think of it?
It's fucking awesome.
It's awesome. Excellent. Yeah.
kids real wild, real crazy. Joe's got a real good thing going here. I hope we can do it next year. It'll be great.
Their starter went, Colin fixed it himself, and just 5 minutes ago we found that his van got broken into with a ton of shit that he used for work and stolen. Throwing change, throwing dollar bills, you guys get more money to bums, help your own, chuck some shit up for my boy. Come up, throw what you got, I don't care if it's a penny, a nickel, there's hundreds of us here, we can help someone out right now.
Yeah. we just try not to like mimic like what like the bands that we're going to be playing with. We try not to sound like them, and you know, if something we're doing sounds like a band that we're friends with, we don't use it.
Yeah, exactly.
Actually, a little game called Grand Theft Auto just came out recently.
A little.
And these guys have a song featured on it. How did that come to be?
They had put together like a hardcore station for this edition of the game. We actually retracked an older song with the old vocals. We recorded that in like 1988. So it sounds good. I'm psyched about it. You know? I wish I saw a fucking nickel for every goddamn one they sold, but you know what are you gonna do?
Yeah.
tour stories? Because you guys are just wrapping up a tour, correct?
Well, we just... The tour was the horror story, dude. We didn't end up going because...
We had to cancel tour because of some financial problems, but it's all right. We'll hopefully bounce back and do it again next year. So luckily we were able to make it work and come out here, so that's all that matters.
Incredible. Are you guys coming off the tour?
We all work and go to school full time and just try to, take a couple days off each month to just drive for 12 hours to play two shows or a show and then drive back home. So it's a lot of money, but it's worth it to us.
Thank you.
changes from day to day, man. You never know who's gonna like your band, who's not. At the end of the day, it just doesn't fucking matter. Get up here because you want to play music, not because you want to be a fucking rock star. All the fancy makeup and tight pants aren't gonna change the fact that you're a fool. So just get up here and keep running.
played well. The kids were nuts. That's all I care about.
Let's mix it up. You know the moves.
We'll be right back.
We got one month for you, and you got a whole fucking weekend. It's gonna be great. For Paint the Black and Madball, this is our last one. If you know it, get to the front. This one's called Forsaken.
Is a really good show. There's so many different kinds of hardcore, you know what I mean? It's not just like beatdown bands, it's not just like posse type of bands, it's not, you know what I mean, old school. It's everything, you know what I mean? And they're all good, and it's just a great vibe in the room, a great positive feeling. more DIY feel to it. It's phenomenal, man. This is a great fest, man. Really
this
good
is
fest.
Hardcore 2008. Last words. What do you have to say?
Last words. Thank you, Joe. 3 years in a row. Thank you very much, man. You hooked us up 3 years in a row, and every year was better than the year before. If you've never been to This Is Hardcore, you got to make it one of these years because it's a good fucking time, man.
What's going on over there? You all right?
Yo, Joe.
Everybody okay? What's up, Joe?
Yo. I heard it's not where you're from, but it's where you're fucking at.
You know where you're at. You know where the fuck you're at. You're in the land of kings.
Brother's responsible. He was into a lot of punk stuff, and just from listening to that, I guess I liked the aggression and stuff. I wasn't into really the whole punk look, I guess. But from that, going to shows to punk shows, just kind of found bands like Minor Threat and stuff like that. And that was kind of the bridge. We'll be right back. deserves a lot of thank yous for, you know, his hard work. Putting something together like this is a headache, probably to say the least, but doing it for the love of hardcore, it's very cool. Old bands, new bands, good shit.
Kids, by the kids. And if you still don't get it, you never will.